I'm Dr. Kay Kirkpatrick, State Senator for Georgia's 32nd District. Welcome back to my Senate Minute. This week, the Senate passed our first bill of the session out of the Senate chamber. Last year, the General Assembly passed a bill that allowed for school zone cameras, but it also allowed drivers coming from the opposite direction of a stopped school bus to pass the bus if there's a turn lane separating the vehicles. This language confused drivers and unintentionally caused accidents with children getting on and off of the bus. Senate Bill 25 clarifies this language to state that drivers can only pass a stopped school bus when a grass median, unpaved area, or physical barrier separates the bus from the approaching traffic. We hope that this language will bring clarity to drivers to avoid any previous confusion. On Thursday, the Senate recognized the issue of human slavery, including sex trafficking, which is not uncommon in other parts of the world, but is unfortunately seen in our very own state. To bring awareness to the issue, senators took part in the End It movement by drawing red X's on our hands. I want to thank law enforcement and all public safety officers who are helping arrest and identify offenders, and to acknowledge the bravery of survivors. Your state senators stand behind you. Also on Thursday, the Interstate Medical Licensure Compact Act, or Senate Bill 16, which I sponsored, passed out of the Senate Health and Human Services Committee. This bill would authorize the Georgia Composite Medical Board to administer the compact currently used in 25 other states. This allows licensure of physicians from other states to practice in Georgia and also adds background checks for incoming physicians. The bill was sent to the Senate Rules Committee and is now set on the calendar to be taken up on the Senate floor Monday. This week, the Senate Education and Youth Committee heard Senate Bill 48, which addresses dyslexia in Georgia. Currently, Georgia has no law to help our educators and school faculty identify and address students who have early signs or any sign of dyslexia. This is a bill that was drafted from the Senate Study Committee on Dyslexia, which met in the interim. Through testimony and speaking with experts, the committee made recommendations which were used to create Senate Bill 48. I'm proud to support this legislation to help students identify dyslexia at an early age, so they can get the help and resources they need to succeed in their learning. Lastly, as I've mentioned before, I sponsored Senate Bill 32, which protects individuals who save animals from locked cars from getting penalized. This bill has received a lot of media coverage this week, which has helped draw attention to and gain momentum on this important issue. I'll be sure to keep you updated as this bill moves forward. This week was full of special guests. On Tuesday, I was honored to have Rabbi Dan Dorsch with me to serve as chaplain of the day in the Senate chamber. I also had several visitors stop by the Capitol. I always enjoy seeing citizens of District 32 under the Gold Dome. Please feel free to stop by at any time. If you can't make it down to the Capitol, please email me at k.kirkpatrick@senate.ga.gov with any questions or concerns. I look forward to updating you as we move through the remaining 29 legislative days, adjourning sine die on April 2nd. Thanks.